I'm John Gerrard. I'm an artist, and I've produced a new simulation, which is an iridescent python. It's called a Dalbertus python, and she performs a figure of eight, biting her own tail, which is this ancient sign called an Ouroboros. And I am collaborating with this man here.
So I'm Richie Houghton, and I have the duty of bringing musical sonic life to John's python. I've created a set of musical sonic loops and vibrations, which we then feed into a system of AI-driven technology by our friends at Bronze. And that simulates a 365-day cycle of the python and brings this audiovisual piece together.
Come in through these big empty halls. We have the title of the work, and then the first thing you encounter is a kind of a totem, a sort of a stack of speakers that for me was always like a sentinel, a little bit like a waiting figure. And then opposite that, you have this really beautiful LED wall, which actually we were given by ROE Visual, who are this amazing LED wall company. And it is showing this iridescent python.
Musically, this piece is really about timelessness, about how when we're living, time just slips out of through our fingers. You know, things can happen so fast, but at the same time just stands still. And then between these two totems, or the wall and the speakers, the python is actually moving at different speeds. The music is, growing and evolving. And it really is a matter of everything standing still and accelerating at the same time.
I'm just fascinated by this idea of information flowing and being completely frictionless. You know, it just streams globally. And, to talk to that through this medium of AI, music and also simulation. But more fundamentally for me, this is an iridescent python. And iridescence in the natural world is both attractive to mates and also repulsive to predators. So it's kind of a push-pull, and the music has that too, like a push-pull, where you're drawn in, but then also push back. But fundamentally, I was interested in the idea of the Ouroboros, which is, an infinite exchange, the cycles of energy exchange, because rebirth is energy exchange. Your energy is pulled up from the landscape and then returns to the landscape upon death. And the snake biting her own tail is, in a way, short-circuiting that system, because she's constantly, infinitely developing. But I think, just to conclude, an underlying thread here is climate heating, because human world, of which we're a part, looks across the great divide at the unhuman world in which the python resides. We're thriving, she's not, she's suffering. And so I think that's in a way, we talked about this right at the start, that idea of, the ambiguity of these times, and to create this kind of almost shamanic hybrid of the python, who's kind of, in a way, part human, part python. And connect her with really the sort of shamanic energy of techno.
I think it's tribal, which music has always brought a sense of meaning and power for humans. But it also, is it the first dance or is it the last dance? Because it's, I said it's 365 days this cycle. It's AI driven, but actually we could disappear and this work would continue.